We're talking to one of the best trainers in boxing, Manny Robles. Big news today that shocked the world.
Yes.
A fighter that you know very well, Errol Spence. Mm-hmm. You've been around the Olympic team for many years.
Correct.
Against Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao, eight division champ. Spence currently the IBF and WBC champ, 147. Break it down.
Manny Pacquiao's not afraid of any challenges. He to fight possibly the top welterweight in the world, and Errol Spence. So it should be an interesting fight. You can never count Manny Pacquiao out, you know, especially what he did in his last fight when he won the world title.
Keith Thurman.
Correct. And, you know, that he amazed every single one of us, I think. Surprised a lot of us after that fight. A lot of people counted him out and thought he was done with his career, and he came out and he won the world title once again. So, you know, and once again with Errol Spence, I wouldn't count him out either.
How do you see the fight unfolding?
Two softballs, man. Should be interesting, right? Two softballs. And Manny Pacquiao's never in a bad fight. Neither is Errol Spence, so it should be interesting. Should be a lot of fun.
From a trainer's perspective, how do you prepare for Manny Pacquiao? How do you prepare for Spence? Spence is undefeated.
Correct.
Manny Pacquiao, his last loss was years ago to Marquez, if I'm not mistaken. He hasn't lost since, correct?
Jeff Horn.
Well, he won that fight.
Yeah, well, yes, he did. Yes, he
that
did.
Was okay.
Yes, he did.
I know he didn't win on paper, but I thought
correct.
He put on
so
the two headbutts, the low blows.
So
the,
did I.
I always joke. Correct. Jeff Horn, the best MMA fighter in boxing.
Right, I was there. I was at that fight in Australia, so I actually thought that Manny Pacquiao won, but you know he's in Australia
correct.
Fighting an Australian fighter, so you know the judges didn't favor him that night, but I thought he won. And it should be an interesting fight. Like I said, it's a good matchup. You know, styles make for good fights. So, you know, I mean, they both like to fight. You know, Errol Spence doesn't run away from a good fight. So you saw what he did with Mikey Garcia.
He boxed.
That was a very good fight. You know,
great game plan.
He's correct. And so, you know, if Mikey Garcia was a full blown welterweight, who knows what could have happened? But as you know, he's not a big guy. But you know, he gave him a good fight. And with Manny Pacquiao, I think it should be interesting. Manny Pacquiao, obviously, a lot of us feel his best days are behind him. But once again, like I said, man, you can never count him out.
One more. Gervonta Davis, the champ at 130, 135, moving up to 140. Yeah. Mario Barrios, what do you think?
Good fight. Interesting fight, right? What are they fighting for? I thought there was only two champions at
Barrios has a WBA champ.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. But junior welterweight, right?
Yeah.
So there should only be, I thought this was the end of two, Saturday night, the undisputed championship of the world.
Actually, this one is the lower one. That Barrios has the bigger one.
That's very
it's still belts, and who am I? I'd love to win anything. So
that's what I'm saying. I thought the WBA junior welterweight title was in dispute Saturday night, not with
one of them is.
One of them is. So how many is there?
There's
how many champions is there at 140?
16. Many. But I think it's great many for fighters because you get a chance to make money, go home, be a superstar. I understand.
I understand when it comes to NABF championships, USBA, NABO, you know, titles that'll get you to the world title fight. But I'm a firm believer in one world champion. There's four major sanctioning bodies, WBC, WBO, IBF and
WBA
and WBA
and IBO.
Correct. Well, no, I said four.
I know what I'm saying. There's
four
and then Ring Magazine belt is another belt.
You know, but I honestly think that between Barrios and Gervonta Davis, it should be another good fight. I mean, Gervonta's moving from 130, 135, now up to 140, new weight class. Barrios is a good fighter at 140, tall. You know, styles make fights. It should make, you know, this is another good matchup, another good fight where I'm eager to see how Gervonta performs at 140 pounds, man.
One fighter I interviewed last week, and you train him, Anthony Herrera.
Yeah.
He's a superstar in the making. We don't know if he's going to the Olympics or not because of the snafu with the Olympic team.
He's not.
Okay, so tell us about him. The kid's super talented, super friendly, very mature.
Yes.
Very intelligent.
Yeah, good kid out of East LA. And unfortunately, they canceled the Olympic qualifier due to COVID. So no Olympics for Anthony Herrera. So now it's time to go pro.
And how would he do as a pro? I mean,
he'll do well. I think he'll do well. You know, maybe turning him pro 115 Superfly or Bantam 118. I don't know. We don't know that yet. But I think he'll do well. He's got more of a pro style than he does an amateur style. So I think he's gonna do well.
Manny, you helped Andy Ruiz beat Joshua. It looks like Joshua's fighting Usyk. What do you think?
Right. Usyk is a softball, good boxer.
Yeah.
Very technically sound. It should be a hell of a fight. You know, Anthony Joshua made some good adjustments when he fought Andy Ruiz the second time. As you know, he can box himself. So I see more of a boxing matchup. You know what I mean? And it's gonna be a battle of who's the smarter fighter. Then I don't really see a matchup where they're gonna clash and really go at it. I see more of a boxing matchup than more than anything else. But I'm eager to see that fight, man. It should be interesting.
And last one, Fury Wilder 3.
Oh man, look, I in the second fight I had Fury by decision and Wilder by knockout, right? Either way, if it went to a decision, Fury. If there was a knockout, I believe it was gonna be the Deontay Wilder. But you're only as good as your last fight, man. And Fury looked spectacular in that second fight. He knocked out Wilder. He stopped, they stopped the fight. So I'm going to have to go with Fury, man. I mean, it's just like, after that last performance, everybody's mind and thoughts are in that last fight. So and unless we get to see a new improved fighter in Deontay Wilder, somebody that can box a little more and not depend so much on his power, then it should be a good fight.
Tell everybody where to follow you on Instagram.
Manuel.boxing.
Make sure to follow him. And, of course, he has a fight this weekend. Yes, and if I come on Anthony Herrera, we're looking forward to what he does. So stay tuned. PSNewsReporting.com. I said back reporting.